innovation is seeing what everybody has seen, but thinking something that nobody has thought of. Good morning, everyone. Today, I, Archit Buddhi Raja,
and I, Mriganka Chakravarti,
both from the river Brahmaputra, are going to present on the topic Reynolds Pens India, then and now. So let's start with the brief introduction of Reynolds as a brand. Reynolds was introduced by Mr. Milton Reynolds back in 1945 in the USA. And you will be amazed to know that he was the first person to introduce the ballpoint pen technology to the entire world. On October 29, 1945, they sold their first pen in New York, and on the first day, they had a footfall of around 30,000 people for purchasing their first ballpoint pen in the America. In 1948, they expanded overseas into the European and other markets.
Reynolds came to India in the year 1986. Now, when they arrived in India, they did not produce the writing instruments on their own. Rather, they licensed it out to a company called GM Pens International Private Limited. Now, this company was headquartered in Chennai, and from there, it pioneered the writing instruments revolution in India. Well, how did they do it? They did it with the implementation of advanced technology and the variety of products that they produced. Manufacturing operations took place in India under the name of Reynolds. Yes, GM Pens International Private Limited produced the products, but the products were marketed under the brand name of Reynolds. Sachin Tendulkar was chosen as a brand ambassador of Reynolds in order to promote the brand in India.
So everyone has used a Reynolds pen, right?
Yes.
Remember that pen with a white colored body and a blue colored cap? That was the best selling pen in India, named as Reynolds 045. So let's move on to product portfolio.
Now, the products of Reynolds in the pen industry can be segmented into four parts, that is ball pens, gel pens, Artoons and others. Under the ball pens category, we find Reynolds 045, which is a very popular pen, and it was the first ballpoint pen that was introduced into India. Then we got Reynolds Liquid Smooth, Reynolds Jetter, that targeted the business class of India, Reynolds Bright, that mainly targeted the school going and the college going students, and Reynolds Jetter Metallica and Jetter Aerosoft. Next, we move into the gel pens category. We have Reynolds Racer Sporty Gel, Express Dry Gel, X Drift Gel, Jiffy Gel, and Trimax.
Reynolds also had a very attractive Artoons category that mainly attracted the kids of India. It included the cartoons in the form of pencil colors, crayons, sketch pens, and stationery kits. The others category include Reynolds 432B HB pencil, Reynolds whiteners, Reynolds erasers, and Reynolds sharpeners. Over to you, Mriganka.
Best selling Reynolds pens in India. Well, as you already know, Reynolds 045 is the first ballpoint pen that was introduced in India. It was the best selling ballpoint pen in India. Reynolds Racer Gel, with its unique selling proposition that it had waterproof gel ink in it. We also have Trimax, which is the best selling pens in the category of rupees 25 to rupees 40 gel pen range.
So here's a video of the unique selling proposition used by Reynolds to clarify what is actually a waterproof gel ink.
Unbelievable! They have cloned Master Blaster Sachin.
अरे कैसा हुआ कमाल है असली कौन?
कौन बता सकता है?
मैं बताता हूँ.
अरे
वर्कर लगाओ.
ओके.
दोनों करें.
हाँ.
कैच.
सिग्नेचर डैश.
Reynolds Racer Gel.
Waterproof.
Reynolds Racer Gel with waterproof ink.
Waterproof.
Waterproof, right? So let's move on to total market share of various pen manufacturing companies in the year 2014. As we can see, the total sale of pen industry was estimated at 222 crores, and out of which the major contributor was Cello, which stood at 33.7% of the market share, followed by Lexi at 28.3%, then Reynolds at 9%, Montex at 8%, Flair at 6%, Parker being at 3.3%, and others manufacturers contributing to a total of 11.7%.
GM Pens International ended license with Reynolds. Archit, can you throw some light on this?
Yeah, definitely. GM Pens International ended their license with Reynolds India because of a conflict of interest between the two companies. Reynolds India wanted that GM Pens should produce and sell their products only in the Indian market, but GM Pens International wanted to enter the international market because of its competitors like Cello and Link were already had their footprints in the international market. So due to the conflict of interest, they ended their license, Reynolds ended its license with GM Pens International in 2016, and soon as they ended the license, GM Pens started its own brand Rurito in 2016. They had a strategic tie-up with German brand Schneider in order to improve the existing quality of their products. They modified the names of the products that they manufactured earlier, like Trimax became P-Max, Jiffy Gel became Jeffy Gel, Bright Gel becomes Bright Gel.
Even though the license ended with Reynolds, GM Pens International generated a revenue of 488.1 crores in the financial year of 2016. In the financial year of 2017, they stood at rupees 500 crores. The total, out of the total 330 crore units that are sold in India, it had 18% market share in the year 2018.
From the revenue of 2016 and 17, the year being when 2016, when GM Pens cancelled their business with Reynolds, it was able to get its stability in the amount of revenue that they generated in 2016, which was 488.1 crore rupees, and 2017 after the conflict they also stood at 500 crore rupees.
So what happened to Reynolds when the license agreement ceased with GM Pens International Private Limited? Well, in the year 2017, they tied up with Flair to relaunch their products in the Indian market so that they could again grab the market that they had lost after losing the license to GM International's Private Limited. The products included Trimax Gel, Jiffy Gel, and the Jeter range.
The entire range that they used to sell before. So these are the market players that as per the Economic Times 2019 rankings in the pen industry. At first we have Cello, that was established in 1995 and with a tagline as Cello, the joy of writing. On the second we have our topic brand Rurito, that was changed from Reynolds to Rurito back in 2016, but was able to have the second largest revenue, or we can say the second largest market share in the Indian market. It started with the tagline Rurito, write the new. On third we have Link, that was established in 1976 with a tagline Link, think it, link it. So in conclusion, I would like to add that in a country like India, it's more important if you have a good footprint and a good product to deliver to the customers rather than the brand name, as in the example of Reynolds and Rurito. These are the sources where we took our data from. Thank you.
Thank you.